Woo cha! It's it's a new week. It's Monday. And like I have said it since I got up today morning, I decided my word for the day is procrastination. Let it be not your friend. Let it just not be your portion this week. I'm just saying, because I'm helping it to reaffirm for myself. Anywho, my name is Cynthia Fierce One. Let's delve into what happened over the weekend in the world of celebrity. And of course, delve into certain things that we think will be happening next or never. I mean, it's gossip. It goes anywhere, really. Auntie Navius, welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Woo, child. The petty has come in the building. So, I was seeing Chaga say all these weird things about Wizzo. And I was like, wait. I thought he just did jail time and I thought they were at peace. You know, I thought they were living that good life, but clearly not. According to reports and rumor, apparently Chaga came out and said, Wizzo needs help. He's running mad. I'm like, Che, what? I've been seeing Wizzo. He doesn't look, he could be depressed. Yes. Depression is real, people. Reach out. But mad? No. Nene nebuza, Chaga Ofachi. Ofachi. Chaga, you are a grandfather in this industry, and I don't even mean that in any slightly disrespectful way. I actually mean it with a lot of respect. I mean, you know that JM Vude of the Mayanja family, that same family that you backed up like about 3 different albums for Chameleon. You were around, we knew you. So I would expect for the respect between you and the Mayanjas to be very mutual, but clearly, and another thing, Janjagalo Kubuza, Chaga, how many times have I sat here and said, Omani, why do I have interview you know take it and but chikuganye? Chaga, when you came onto this scene, you came in as a backup artist, as an artist. Ngamu yimbi, tetwaku manida mu management. And what's so annoying is that the Mayanja family has forever drugged you in the mud. Like bakwe vida mudasi bebalina ko, they just bakula babulabi, but you still maintain. I understand you had a very strong relationship with the Let Radio. He always kept you around. But now it's Wizzo's time, and he doesn't have time for that because he's a Mayanja, and it's like the Mayanjas and their backup artist syndrome, just there is no sync. What? Why don't you get that? I was even in shock. They told me, walo watunde nyumba. Good life ekube chivulu. No jitunda, good life nekube chivulu. Te wafuna munaka. So, who are you to keep making these losses and looking like a damn-ass clown? Who are you? Tewero wozako, Chaga. I mean, if you want to have say in this industry, don't say it as a manager because you failed so miserably at it. You know? Obo yagala kubera industry, come and sing. Tukubwa mubimba, zenaba gambia, 2019. Sicha yagala walala wololo. No. If you have a message, put it in a song. Let's get it from there. Like, I could educate Chaga on ways to make money, but I cannot waste that time right now. I can't. Because his head is so stuck down in the sand. Oba, he's waiting for these kids to first come up and just write, like, do like a Facebook Live. I don't get it. Chaga, where's when you were Wizzo and good life? Go do other things, eh? And they told me you're not doing well financially. I guess we're all not doing well financially. The economy is like Matia said, but guy, chilabemu now, chilabemu. Ah. I guess again I have to call out Vapolomota, Tulivako. So King Saha had his Bidi Bidi concert, that was on Friday. Yes, the people did show up, but it was like literally the most disorganized concert I have seen thus far. And given it was what opened up our year, I'm like, ew. All that disorganization. Yo, Saha, first of all, big up on yourself. Do you think Obacha Mkwata Vagalant, he didn't expect for it to, but you had so much time. You had different artists pushing for you. Everybody was raved about this show. I expected you to nail it. Now, we had horrible sound. That was one. There was too much going on stage. Again, King Saha came driving himself in a Range Rover. Now, this is the part that has killed me and the people who understand TV and camera. He came driving himself in a Range Rover, right, to get on stage. Now, when he gets on stage, the ramp where he goes down at, Range Rovers are right-hand drives, right? Cameraman, if I could left. Saha Vidideoku, right? I was like, wait, this is so disorganized. Even something this small, y'all couldn't remember that. couldn't you? But at the end of the day, his vocals were okay. You know, when he sings, everybody shut up. Na ya kavyo kali ku stage. Khalifa aganaga bana. Khalifa aganaga tata chivoko fire. This is what I want to say. Oba mweta go college chibina gwende Maria che na kuzino sabiriza nyo sente mu ba crowd. Atenga ba mazo kuja ne basasula sente bacha spending up. Man, me I'm tired of people who make us want to part ways with all our kalito money. I've already come out for entertainment. Don't ask me for money. Tugenda ba kolede chibi na association. Tujiite chi. Kusabidiza agenda association. Kusabidiza agenda association. You and Mariachi should be a part of it, I'm just saying. But anyway, the concert did happen. I don't have much to write home about because it was all over the place. I wasn't, but good for him. Zavu de. Zengwaga la bidi. Hey, bidi bidi. After I just talked about Sao and I sang that song, I, the next story that I'm going to do, So, you all know how MC Cats and Fear have been an item for quite some time. Yes, they have. They've been an item. We talked so many things. They went through so much. And we all couldn't believe that a woman could do that much damage to a man that short, but it's possible. Hi, Willis. What's good? I'm just saying, Cats and Fear have been through it. He's proposed on almost every stage he has emceed on. And it was growing. They have a child together until the word came out. Now, apparently these people have been having so many marital issues. And their marital issues spewed, yes, marital. Okay, cohabiting. I'm sorry, I used the wrong word. They've had so many cohabiting issues. And it finally came out that they actually have been separated for quite some time. It's been like 6 months, and they were trying to keep it afloat for the business. Because remember, he manages her, and that also took its toll on him when yesterday I got up to a screenshot from MC Cats' WhatsApp status update. And he was saying, y'all don't even know how much I tried. Y'all don't even know how much I've gone through. You do not understand. But as of now, I'm openly telling everybody I am not managing Thea, and, you know, we're done. I was like, okay, I feel you on that. I understand that he actually did try. This side has two stories, right? But because I'm a gossip girl, immediately we try to find out what could have been the issue. Now, I'm not trying to shame no one, but apparently the biggest problem in that relationship was Fear cheating. Oh, did she cheat? Ho-ho! Apparently she has cheated left, right, center, makati, waguru. And then you'd be like, would expect MC Cats to be the one doing that because he's the one with the crazy nightlife, he's the one with all these girls following him and all of that. But he kept it together, and rumor has it was her. But then again, there's always two sides to each story, and I'm not even going to delve into that. Do I feel it was a good decision for him to take away the bad negativity and that bad vibe? Definitely. Why would you let someone who is not appreciative of what you're bringing to the table and a lot from you walk away? And he has done that. As for Fear, man, it's sad because I found out that he found out that kagai kate doktambula na kombo akaitati kazini we. That guy has been banging that one. See, he has banged in different premises, different cities, different districts. He has done it all. I was like, wow. Zero chills. Now, anyway, Cats, live and let live. I mean, you're a young man. Hey! I was going to say you're a young man, you'll find love, but judging by the number of baby mamas you got, I think it's about time you finally understood the certain things are not for you. Anywho, that's been my time. Of course, that was a tiny bit of it was a recap of what happened during the weekend. But now that the week is upon us, honey, we are going to be sipping this tea and throwing so much shade. I have a feeling this week is going to be lit, like so lit. I was listening to Full Figure educating Bad Black. Have you ever seen a kettle judging a teapot? I mean, how? What moral authority does Full Figure have to tell Bad Black what she did? You'll get all of those and a lot more probably tomorrow or within the week. Anywho, at Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop at Tina Fierce One. Like, follow the pages. On Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. Yes. And that's my time. I'm out. Peace.